Hi, this is Eileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about the building blocks of magics. At the end of this video, you'll be able to find your way around the user interface, and you'll become familiar with the geometric terminology of magics, so that you can use it to its full potential. Let's get started. First, here is our workspace. Our workspace is our sandbox. We also have scenes. In Magics, scenes are 3D representations of your machines. The user interface of Magics is based on ribbons. Every ribbon contains functions specific to a certain type of action in Magics. For example, if you'd like to do fixing, you can go to the Fix ribbon to find all the functions relevant to fixing. Magics also has a quick access bar. The quick access bar gives you options for loading projects, saving projects, importing parts, saving parts, unloading parts, undoing and redoing our actions, and moving to our home view. The home view is a zoomed out view where you can visualize all the parts loaded in your workspace. If you're not able to find a specific function in the ribbons, you can always go to the quick search bar and start typing a part of the name of the function you're looking for. You'll be immediately presented with a list of all the functions that have a similar name. Magics also has toolbars. By default, Magics comes with a marking toolbar. Marking is a function used in combination with other functions to modify specific regions in a part. We're going to see more about marking in a separate tutorial video. On the right-hand side, we have our pages. The pages allow us to change the visualization of our parts, visually inspect our parts, and display information about our parts, among other things. In the View tab under the View pages, we can change the visualization of our parts from shade to wireframe to a combination of shade and wireframe, a triangulated view, and even a simple bounding box. If you'd like to inspect the inside of your parts immediately, you can even toggle transparency. In the Multi-section tab under the View pages, you can activate cross-sections on your parts. This could be on a single dimension or a combination of multiple dimensions. If you'd like custom sections, you can also use the other functions available. You can choose to only display the sections on your part as you see on the screen. You can choose to hide the side of your parts from the origin and hide the side away from origin. Down in the Part pages, we have the Part List tab, where we can see a list of our parts loaded. We can select and deselect certain parts. We can hide or show parts. We can change the visualization type, add transparency, and change color. We can also inspect other properties such as memory state, part name, fixing info, and so on. In the Part Info tab, we can display information about individual parts on their coordinates, their dimensions, their triangle number, the volume, surface area, and so on. And a part fixing info, we can quickly visualize the fixing status of our parts. Further down in the pages, we have pages for adding annotations and textures, for taking measurements and creating reports, and pages for fixing. Let's bring our parts back to their original state. The last but not the least, Magics also comes with a context menu, which is also known as the right-click menu. The right-click menu contains different functions based on where you're right-clicking in Magics. For example, if you're right-clicking on a part, you're going to get functions that are relevant to a part. For example, unloading, translating, rotating, and saving. And if you're clicking on the empty workspace, you're going to get a different context menu with functions for creating default parts, importing parts, and loading scenes. The user interface of Magics is fully customizable, so you can keep what you want to keep and remove what you want to remove. Let's move on to the geometric terminology of Magics. Here, I'm going to need only one part, so I'm hiding the other two parts. I'm going to change to the triangulated view to get a better explanation. I'm going to select my part, and I'm going to use the marking tools. The marking tools will allow me to demonstrate the different geometric elements in Magics. So let's start with the triangle. The triangle has a normal and three edges. Ideally, every edge of a triangle must touch the edge of another triangle. Triangles are the building blocks of STL files. Next on, planes. A plane is defined by the distance and the angle between a click triangle and the triangle surrounding it. Within tolerance values, a plane can be considered relatively flat. Next on, the surface. The surface is similar to a plane, but the surface also takes curvature into account. In Magics, surfaces are surrounded by a wireframe. And the last but not the least, the shell. A shell is an uninterrupted collection of triangles. So when I click on this part, the whole part is marked because all the triangles are uninterruptedly connected to each other. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.